Houston station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground, your weekly look at what's happening on board the International Space Station. I'm Dan Hewitt. The crew started off the week by saying farewell to a Russian cargo vehicle. Progress 55 undocked Monday evening after spending more than 3 months attached to the station. Like every Progress, it was loaded up with trash and disposable items, which will be incinerated when the ship passes back through the Earth's atmosphere. And since it just doesn't feel like the ISS without a Progress attached, the next one was ready for launch just 2 days later. Lifting off from Baikonur in Kazakhstan, Progress 56 sped its way to the station on Wednesday night, docking just 6 hours after launch and bringing about 5,700 pounds of food, fuel, and supplies to the crew of Expedition 40. Crew member Alexander Gersh spent some time preparing the station for guests a little more accustomed to floating. He set up the ISS aquatic habitat that can host several different species of fish, which while in space behave very similarly to a human who doesn't exercise. The small school of zebrafish that will soon be making a trip up to space will help teach scientists about the basic mechanisms behind muscle loss and how that loss can be recovered. This week's Twitter question comes from Steven, who asks, what experiments conducted in microgravity have led to commercial products on the market? Well, one good example comes from a very important field of medical study in space, bone loss. Without proper countermeasures, astronauts in microgravity lose bone mass. And similar bone loss occurs in people on Earth with osteoporosis, a debilitating disease that affects millions. One investigation back on Expedition 4 provided researchers with data that was helpful in finalizing development of a new drug called Prolia that's currently on the market to help strengthen the bones of women with osteoporosis. You can check out the hundreds of experiments that have taken place on board the ISS at nasa.gov/station. And make sure to keep sending your questions and comments using the hashtag #SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.